Just a couple updates. At council January meeting, the city council approved the issuing of the certificates of participation or COPs, funding in the amount of $8.2 million for the upfront cost of the pool and the park. There will be a second round issued later, but this, I think financially it worked out better to issue in two different blocks. So for those of you that did see that in January, I know Jimmy had an article on it and also then covered it in the council meeting too. Last council meeting, there were a few minor issues we had to work through when we went to do the ponds. It appears that there was, when we went to do the title company, that it was not, couldn't get a clear title report on the recreation park because there were still some unimproved streets and alleys that had not been vacated. So we cleared this issue up and had the council approve at their February 16th meeting to vacate, for those of you that may have saw that in the newspapers of last week or week before. The council meeting, and it was more just, for some reason, those streets and alleys were platted back to college a long, long time ago and just were unimproved and had never been vacated. So it was more kind of a housekeeping thing. By vacating those, it gave us the title work to go ahead and issue the bond and the debt for building the new aquatic center. A couple other things too, we're working through some playground inspection issues that was pointed out by our new risk management company. So working on bringing some of those into compliance. The street department went out and removed two pieces of playground equipment in recreation park on the very far east end of the park. It was the roller slide and then the swing that we replaced with the ADA swing, the top swing last year, a year ago. The swing that was in its place got put over in that area too, so they had to take that one out of commission completely. So if anybody drives by Rec Park and looks a little empty in that playground equipment, that's why. So still a few other items, but nothing major at this time. I think we have to take out of play or completely remove it. And the only other thing I have is that the LWCF grant, park board, and then the last parkland committee working with Vireo. So I'd like to thank Larry for all of his hard work on extra hours that Larry put in on that. Actually, Steve did.
And I had frozen pipes in the middle of it.
Yes.
Oh, my gosh. Yes. No.
It was raining.
So we do have the, it's front and back. This is the LWCF grant for the $250,000 in the family amenity area. We also submitted to the recreational trails grant. The council approved both of those also by resolution at their last council meeting. So both of those did get in and get submitted. So
nice job, guys.
Fingers crossed.
Awesome.
It's a lot of paperwork and a lot of questions and a lot of research in the last couple weeks. So, but we got it done and submitted. Fingers crossed.
We should appreciate it.
Yeah, thank you.
Well, that is all I have at this time.
Okay, just try to pay for myself. Okay, then moving right along. That means we're ready for new business. On the agenda for new business, first up would be the new aquatic facility. You saw the notes there from the most recent aquatic committee meeting. It was on February 18th. We had at that meeting both Lamprey Nearson and our contractor at risk, Carruthers. So we just kind of looked at the most recent design. They gave us their maximum bid price, the correct terminology. And we sort of compared that to the budget we've got. And of course, the max bid price was a little bit higher than the budget. So we need to find some ways to reduce that down by either creating some bid alternates that can go out with the bid packages, or just, you know, cutting some pieces of the design out completely. We're not done with that work yet. It's probably gonna take one more committee meeting, hopefully next week, to get through that, get those things submitted back to Lamprey and Nearson, and so they can update the design with those final choices. So that's kind of where we're at. Any questions? Okay. So that's it for the aquatic facility update then. Does somebody want to make a update for the new community park, and I know we've got Vireo here for a whole presentation, so. Well, do you wanna go first, or do you want a committee to update first? Who wants to?
I think Matt's your chair, so.
Yeah, Matt.
I'd say Steve.
Okay, all right.
If you wanna just jump in.
Okay, so, we were here a month ago to update you. We met with the park committee. There's still, we have some questions that we do need answered, probably either, if not tonight, in another park committee meeting here, hopefully next week or the following week. And Larry just chimed in. So, just a reminder, this is the plan that was approved by the voters. And then this is our revised plan, which you see up here. All the elements that we had in the voter initiative are in there. The only major change is we're now coming off of Northland Drive into the park. And then we have developed some overflow parking here in case you have a large event. And then we have a family gathering area, and we also, it's hard to see, but see it on the board there, there's a third soccer field for future use. And then the family amenity area, which we called it, is right here, which we just submitted the grant for the year-round restroom. So our first thing is just to review the concession building. We did have a question last time. There's two, and some of you weren't here, so this is probably the first time you're seeing this. So again, we have area for concessions, dry storage. We may be able to reduce this overall footprint, possibly. And we have a men's and a women's and two family restrooms. One of the big things that was the difference, we have two options here, was the roof design. There's this large angled roof.
Can you see that okay?
And then the other option, oh, here's the elevation. Do we have the other option in here? Yeah. So, and the other option is just the standard sort of hip roof. And I don't know that there's a big impact to cost. It would probably be more an aesthetic and long-term maintenance question for you all to think about. And then here's sort of standard hip roof design. So those two options are out there. The hip roof or the angled roof. We weren't very specific in our grant, so that could be well. Cost. So, like I said, first time, just like you're doing in your pool project, we're gonna have to make some hard decisions about what goes and what stays. Our current costs. Estimates are broken out into these categories, and Larry, do you want to kind of go through these and kind of point through them?
Sure. Site work, that includes all the grading of the site. It's about 30 acres total that we're disturbing, so it's pretty large site. Stormwater, drainage, 200,000. Roadway and parking, a little over 600,000 for that total. These are asphalt drives on an aggregate base. Then we have lighting in here at the moment along the drive and in the parking lot. Utilities, right now we have numbers for, preliminary numbers for sanitary sewer and water. Combined, that totals 922,000. That may adjust a little bit once we get a report from the utilities department on what that is. We don't have a number quite yet for electrical service to the site, but it's accessible. Buildings, this includes the restroom, concessions, building at the center of the baseball plaza, a shelter for the amphitheater, and a maintenance pole barn for equipment on site. Sidewalks and baseball plaza, about $300,000, a little over. Site furnishing, this includes benches, trash receptacles, all those sorts of things. Park entry sign, included a number in there, I figured that probably ought to be part of the park, the new park. Landscaping, baseball fields, all three together. This includes lighting, irrigation, and, you know, dugouts, backstops, fence around the whole thing. We've got a warning track around the infield mix. All of that for those three fields is $1.4 million. Baseball plaza area, playground. We have a playground located right in the central area. $200,000, and then the soccer fields. Two soccer fields. These are with irrigation and with lighting. Total about $666,000. So that brings us total construction costs. We're at $6.7 million right now. Soft costs. So total project costs are $7.3 million where we stand today. So got a lot of decisions to make to get down to our $5.2 million. So we began to look at some opportunities for what could be alternates. How are we going to get there? And these are some of those decisions that will need to be made. Baseball field irrigation, soccer field irrigation. Irrigation and lighting are two big ticket items, obviously. Some other options could be amphitheater shelter, scoreboards, the playground, lighting the roadway and the parking. Maybe that can come down a little bit. Maybe restrooms and concessions. So those items total 2.4. If you removed that 2.4 from the bottom line I just showed you, that puts us under 5. So obviously, I think there's some things in there that you're not going to want to totally get rid of. Some things you may be okay with, but we're going to have to work through that. Future improvements. This is, we updated the park master plan. We found some opportunities for other things too. We wanted to get that captured in the final master plan for the site. So we identified an opportunity for a future soccer field. This would be a 240 foot by 360. That's full regulation, high school size. Two future baseball diamonds. We'll grade those with phase one, but won't install anything for them as part of phase one. So there's two future fields planned. Future destination playground, a splash pad area with a couple of shelters and a restroom. See where that is?
That was the grant, was for the restroom. Part of the in-kind is the two shelters, and also part of the in-kind was the sidewalks around it.
Additional parking there. We have a trailhead up at the bend of the road that would lead out to nature hiking trails, mountain bike trails, what have you, out in the wooded area. Somerville interpretive note. This is an interpretive note that could be by future trail. There's an old railroad rail bed that goes across, as you know, over there. If that becomes a trail someday, you might want to have a note that tells maybe a little bit about the history of Cayman and Somerville. We also thought about putting a garrison flag there as well. Family games area. There's an area of the property just along off of 8th Street as you come in that could be an opportunity for things like family games, you know, cornhole, maybe a couple of pickleball courts. Could be more just kind of scenic views, looking out. That's the highest point really on the site, and so it could create some great opportunities looking over the park down into the soccer fields and out across. What else? Nature trails and paved trails. We have a paved trail, I don't know if you can see it on there, that goes around the fields, goes up, and then it, kind of ties it up to the future nature trails up in the north. Okay, with our target schedule, so tonight we have brought a 50% set of drawings for review that we will give you, along with a drainage report from Marlin West.
Okay.
So we're really at about 50% CDs, roughly, to kind of tell you where we're at in progress. So we really need then basically confirmation that, hey, this is, we're in the right path. We'll want to work through still connecting it to our budget that we're moving forward.
Do you also have those digitally?
I do.
Can you send the stormwater report?
Yes.
Separate digitally also then?
Yep.
Thank you.
So then we're looking at late April for a 95% set of bid documents and going out to bid mid-May. Beginning construction hopefully this summer, or like the grand opening next summer. We need a couple of growth seasons to get vegetation established before we start planting on fields and whatnot. So we're probably looking at next summer.
That's the presentation. We'll open up for questions. Matt, you weren't here yet, but we thought it might be good to get the park committee together in the next week or two.
Yeah, looking at the budget numbers, I think that's necessary.
Yeah.
Okay, you want to schedule that now?
Yep.
All right, myself. Let's see, Monday, Thursday, I've got kids soccer until 6:30.
I could
do Tuesday, Wednesday, Friday myself next week.
I can do any of those three too.
Something on that, it would be Monday, so I can do it any other night.
Plan for Tuesday?
Yeah.
I'm good with that.
Okay.
Tuesday the 2nd.
Tuesday the 2nd.
What time?
6? We expect it's going to run long, and we want to go 5:30. Steve, how long are you going
to
argue?
We'll get it to you so you can look at it, and we'll get through things.
Okay. 6 o'clock, Tuesday the 2nd.
You get out of me down here, Matt?
Yeah, I think this is as easy as anything.
Okay.
If this is an option.
Definitely.
Okey-doke. Any other comments on that? Questions from anybody?
I'm not lagging, I was just going to ask. Was it for soccer fields also?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, we had...
that's what I was thinking you had said.
Soccer field lighter.
Sure.
Okay. So we had internally talked about just lighting one, but these central poles here will also hold the lights for this field on this side. So you're almost into two if you buy one. So.
And you said you've got that whole stack electronic.
Mm-hmm.
If you would forward those, what's the cutoff? Like I'm thinking it might make sense if I sift through everything and have a whole list of questions for you guys. What's the cutoff? When would you want those submitted to you guys so you have a chance to think about them before then?
Before meeting?
Yeah, like would you want those by Monday, close of business, so
yeah,
you can think through on Tuesday?
Yeah.
Okay.
Matt, were you here when they mentioned the grants that have been submitted?
No, I knew that they had done it, but I...
You knew about those already?
Yeah.
Okay. Just wanted to make sure you heard that.
Yeah.
And do you have... have that 250 from the first one potential in this?
In it?
From last year's, yeah.
It's not necessarily in it.
It hasn't been applied to the budget.
It hasn't been applied to the budget. We're still assuming that the budget is
what it is until we hear.
Yes, and that was, what, 5? Or 5.2?
I thought it was
the budget.
250 cash.
No, the budget for the park.
Oh, I'd have to look, I don't remember which exactly was, but I'll send an email out on that.
On that grant, at what point does it make sense to ask a question to see what the timeline looks like so we know?
We have multiple times.
Yeah.
It's at the National Park Service right now. So our contacts at the Missouri Department of Natural Resources, they don't know either.
Yeah. So just as a reminder, that grant was $250,000 to be applied for the grading of these ball fields. And it was associated with the early tract only. This year's grant was same part associated with a different tract of land for the family amenity area. Again, for $250,000 for construction of that year-round restroom. And we had a lot of community support letters that came in, which will really, really help the chances of that. We didn't, other than the voter initiative, we didn't have, we had support letters, but not offering to volunteer.
But I still think, fingers crossed, I think we're looking pretty good because we've made it out of state.
Yeah.
To national approval.
I'm not afraid to call the DC office if necessary.
Call in some of your old connections?
I don't have any old connections. I can call and harass people with the best of them.
They've asked every question in the book, and I had submitted last year just the executive summary, which is 3 or 4 pages rather than the big document of the environmental assessment that you did to acquire the property. And so they wanted the whole thing, and we were able to send it to them in an email quickly. And we're assuming the same thing will happen this year because they just sent them the executive summary, so they'll follow up on that. We did also submit section 106 for both tracks for the development of the grading here as well as everything over here.
And so, you know, I just do want to mention too, you'll probably see next month at the Planning and Zoning Commission, since they were separate parcels, then the little triangle in the bottom was old, leftover remnant of the old railroad track that the city of Cameron still owned. As well as the entrance, it's kind of like the sewer treatment plant on a little bit, and we just worked through the 35. There was a deed overlap on the eastern parcel. We just cleared up the title work on that, and it was the city, so that owns the 35 feet. So we'll be going to planning and zoning to make it official to combine all of those. 1, 2, the overlap is 3, the triangle is 4, and then the entrance by Northland Drive is 5. Combine all those little 5 parcels and make this one large park. Then we'll get it recorded and down to the county to record it also. But I know we had it on the agenda. I didn't put it on there, but still something to think about is what is the name of this park? I mean, as we move along and start submitting grant applications and start recording it, is this...
That can be a topic, yeah. Tuesday's subcommittee meeting.
Okay, all right. We're getting close. We need a no-name park, or just call it Camp Park, or Community Park, or...
That one's
always there.
I had one question on the grading on the baseball fields. Are they graded from the home plate out, or are they graded
They are. The high point will be sort of your central plaza space, and then there's sort of a high point in here, and then they drain outward this way. Which one?
Yeah, if you get up close here, you can see the contours, how they're going. So like you said, the high point is here. Now these two fields, the way it's up, they shed across like this, and this one down here, so that ridge breaks there.
This one is more crowned down the center of your large field. So is this one and this one. So these are the only two that are sloped a little bit differently.
Yeah, I'm assuming I'll pepper you guys with questions once I get a chance to digest everything.
Well, that's what we're here for, and hopefully we've already thought about it.
For ease for you guys for questions before the meeting, does it make sense to for everybody to send them directly to you, or would you like for anybody else that has questions to funnel them through me and I'll accumulate?
You have one set.
Yeah.
Okay. Any other questions shipping to me and I'll forward?
Did you have a question on the maintenance?
Yeah, I did. So we have the maintenance building setting down here. So thought was that, you know, maintenance could access the park from the side and your maintenance building sitting here. There is an option of putting it here, more centrally located in the park. And, you know, that's just a matter of, you know, what your all's preference is. You know, my concern here is, you know, this is really not going to be accessed very often, so it's kind of tucked towards the outer edge of your park, that it might be a little bit more safe if it were in the middle. Easier to get to, if there's an amphitheater event or, you know, whatever. If there's room down here, there's room up here, it's just a matter of where we put it.
Sure, it will be gated off too.
This will be gated back here, and then maybe eventually move it to here once the family games area opens. But you know, this could serve as a outlet if you did have a holiday lighting display. People could come in and out this way.
I would think that makes sense to defer to Drew and his staff on just what all is going to be in there, and you know, we don't want to waste hours on end shuttling stuff back and forth if it makes sense putting it in the middle, but at the same time we don't want to put it dead center as a focal point in the middle of the park if it's not going to benefit us.
Well, I guess that was our thought, because inevitably anytime you have any type of shop, whether it's mowing or parks or anything or street, we always have to, you know, store a little bit extra gravel or patch or sand or pallets of seed, or we take out an old swing set, and you know, we have pieces and parts and wood chips, down branches before we haul them off or chip them up. I mean, there's going to be piles of materials sometimes that we'll want to set beside wherever the building is. So I guess our thought, plus also using, you know, like UTVs or mowers or just trucks running back and forth between other parks, it'll probably be easier for us to come off of 8th, which hits Elm. Which then we take Elm and cut right over like 3rd Street and, you know, down to our other park. So those are kind of the basis for the location that we chose. But
you chose those down at the south end there? And if you had it down there, park staff could access that building even in the middle of a tournament and not have to be going through an active parking lot.
True. The disadvantage, though, is, you know, it's not as visible, so the probability of theft can be higher. We have a building like that in our cemetery right now that, and it has been broken into in the past, but I think we've taken some pretty good measures to help limit that in the future.
There is a detention basin that is in this area. How far did you say, Larry, it was?
So from where the building is to the top of where the slope is, the detention basin, there's 60 feet of space. So it gives you some room to have some storage area, you know, whatever.
Perfect.
Okay.
So I suppose it's like anything. The more room you have, the more we'll find
reasons. You'll use it, yeah. Exactly.
We'll get it next week and just keep piling stuff. So maybe we should shrink that down a little, huh?
Yeah.
It's whatever you guys at the board desire, but those were our thoughts on access off of the southern end and
like.
To me, I think it makes more sense to put it down there at the south, unless there's a compelling reason to have it more centrally located. But it's not like you're trying to go 5 miles in each direction, it's.
But, you know, maybe in 5, 10, 15, 20 years down the road, we put in those additional soccer fields and additional baseball fields, maybe at that point, we have an office out there too, and a welcome center, maybe at that point you have more mowers and stuff on another building further north.
Yep.
Is there any kind of like gateway, like walking into the fields, like flags or anything, I'm just curious, you see that sometimes.
So, generally, you would have, now this won't be fixed, but generally, if you want to do tournaments, you want to have a sort of gated area where you collect your fees. So yeah, that would be here once you enclose all of this.
That walk, see, we're keeping a search, emergency vehicle access, so that walk will be a thicker walk than most others, and it'll be wide enough to accommodate an ambulance to get in and out of there.
All right, get our shovels and start digging.
You guys got your committee meeting scheduled, so.
Corey, did I miss, apologize, what was the date on your aquatic?
We didn't schedule it, and I don't know if we can without the committee member here, without them, or near Senator Brothers here.
Okay.
I may just have to send an email.
Okay.
And see if we can get one together, but I'd like it to be next week. So, I'll get something sent out. We have one more bullet point on new business, this is up to y'all, whether we want to discuss this tonight or table it, just keep it on the agenda. Are we ready to make any changes in our COVID restrictions in parks?
I haven't seen any reason to make any updates to this point. We're not really to park season yet, but it's right around the corner.
Yeah. Seems like we could probably wait one month and see what happens and make a decision.
Maybe there will be some new guidance come out. I have always hesitated to make big decisions without some sort of guidance somewhere, you know, or especially when we go against the existing guidance.
Something changed, because I know the schools are releasing, going to start back in class, what, the 15th March?
Mm-hmm.
High school? So something's probably changed somewhere.
But part of that's the COVID rate.
Good job.
Queen County, I think, was below, well, I know it's below 10%. I was just telling that last time.
Yeah.
So I'm sure that has a lot to do with it.
Everybody,
I think it's down like 6%. I think it's down to like
6%. Park season.
Yeah, I think it makes sense to stay in a certain pattern for right now.
Any other thoughts?
I would agree with that.
All right. We'll put it on the agenda for next month.
Yeah.
All right, that's it for new business then. All we've got left is miscellaneous. All right. Not hearing any.
I would like to say that I think this is an exciting time. We've waited a long time. It's really exciting.
It is. It's very exciting. All right, well, then I would entertain a motion to adjourn. Do we need to set the next meeting?
Next meeting is March 25th. I assume same time, same place.
Same bat channel.
Mm-hmm.
Thursday, what did you say? March 25th?
Mm-hmm.
That looks good, everybody.
Yeah.
So I'll make the motion to adjourn.
Second.